How's it going, New Fane High School? Mr. Arnie here. Welcome to another edition of History Comes Alive, brought to you by Room 120 Productions. Today, we'll be reviewing British imperialism.
Did you know that there are three reasons why British imperialized other countries, including the social Darwinism, white man's burden, and for the good of the empire? And the first one we're talking about is Africa, with the main thing being the Berlin Conference, when the Europeans broke up Africa without any of the Africans' consent. Let's move on to the next one.
Hey guys, Mr. Arnie back here again. Mr. McDonald just reviewed Africa with you. Now let's take it back and review India. This is significant because India was considered to be the crown jewel of the British Empire until a guy by the name of Mohandas Gandhi came along and led a civil disobedience protest all throughout the country. Eventually, he was able to tell the British to hit the road, Jack, and never come back. And eventually, India became its own sovereign country.
Hey guys, we already did Africa and India, and now we're going to finish up with China. China was a pretty big world power until British imperialism came along. They started importing opium. It destroyed the Chinese economy until they had the Boxer Rebellion. Not that kind of Boxer, but it eventually drove foreign influence out, and China was able to get its independence. See ya.
Alright guys, that's all we have for you for today, for History Comes Alive. Next week, Mr. McDonald and I will be reviewing old dead famous people. Take care, guys. A guy by the name of Mohandas Gandhi was responsible for... Alright, just cut it.
Got it.
The guy's like... I'm not...
Hey guys, I'm back. Guys, that's it for...
Alright guys, that's it for History Comes Alive. Next week we're going to be reviewing Mr. McDonald's foot fungus. What do you want me to do?
I want you to go on the screen. It's right now. I'm just showing a picture of nothing.
Everybody just have a good time. Clap!